Why was the Predator script changed? What's up everyone, Carlos here. So I wanted to go over some news about this topic. As many of you recall, a long time ago, we had some news that the movie would include more Predators, specifically Commando Predators. They were going to work with the Stargazer base, but that idea was thrown out the window and completely changed. However, they still filmed the footage, but it was cut from the movie. So what happened? Well, there's an interview on Yahoo Movies that goes into the answer. It also addresses why Edward James Olmos was removed from the cast. The details about the interview are addressed by Shane Black. Now, it goes on to say this. The character played by Edward was possibly trying to recruit the first Predator. But when they went back to look at the footage, they realized there was one too many villains in the movie. So they were forced to remove this character from the movie. But it was a decision they did regret. Now, I'm kind of curious how the movie would have turned out if he was never removed from the film. Having more than one villain in the movie could be interesting. Maybe having more than one person with the same goal could have been different. Or perhaps they would each have their own agenda, which could later cause some more conflict between the different parties. But in the end, Sterling K. Brown was left to hold the single role of the villain in the movie, the Predator. And I think he did all right. However, I felt it just wasn't evil enough. The news article also mentions about the Ark site scene being different. The set and the sequence were the same. This included the loonies breaking into the Ark, freeing the kid and running away. Meanwhile, the Predator would then chase them afterwards. When they started editing the special effects, it just didn't seem to flow very nicely. There were early signs that the movie did not look like a big budget film. As they watched Predators run around in daylight, it just seemed a bit off or unusual, at least for the picture. So that entire scene was changed to nighttime. Shane also mentions that this was a fairly expensive change for the movie, and Fox Studios went along with it. And this was a good decision. This entire scene shot at night was a better idea. This scene was actually rebuilt at another location. They placed the ship back in, restaged the attack on the ship, and the rescue of the kid. All of this was done at night. He also gives us details as to why the Predators were so interested in Quinn McKenna's son. Later in the movie, the ultimate Predator captures the boy because his disability is seen as the next step in evolution. Because for some reason, he was able to decipher the Predator language. He makes a very good point in all of this by saying, there's one theory that they're seeing something that other people don't see. Another part of the article talks about bringing back Arnold as Dutch. The studio was open to include him in a small role for the third act, but when he asked Arnold about this, it was somewhat of an embarrassing question. He said this, "Well, if I was featured more, yeah, but what you're suggesting is that you're creating this new thing and just using me to bless it." And so I said, yes. And so I was not surprised when he said, "Look, I wish you luck, but that's too small of a role for me." And that's why Arnold was not in this movie. The movie was supposed to go into the idea of humans being aware of predators. They established a watch post to monitor when the hunters returned to Earth. The story was about the next incursion, with humans watching the skies, and not from the point of view of the predators. There are plans to visit the predator homeworld at some point, and when we do visit, we will see everything about them. But this movie was to keep the focus on humans. And the last bit of news is regarding some reshoots that took place a while ago. Part of the reason which is now public is because of a sex offender who had a role in the movie. It took Fox Studios a while to respond to this, but he was eventually removed from the movie. During an interview with The Hollywood Reporter, Olivia Munn said this, "I'm happy they did this, because I'm proud of the work we did in this movie. We all worked really, really hard, and I would not be able to morally stand behind this movie with this guy in there." So, that covers all the news on the Predator movie. How do you feel about the changes to the movie so far? Do you think it would have been better having more Predators and more than one villain? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. You can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Sometimes I post other things on there. Thanks for watching. My name is Carlos, or Acid Glow, and I'll see you in the next hunt.
All units, we have a system error. Xenomorph specimens on the loose. Get to the Ox area now!